spoofed Gilligan's Island. We had spoofed Star Trek. And I had this idea for, you know, what other fun genres could we go after of spoofing Batman. And my initial idea was that it would be Bob, and Bob would be Bat Bob. And I had a vision of a teaser scene to kind of tell people, you know, this is what it's going to be like, of Bat Bob, you know, standing on the edge of a building, looking down at night, you know, very dramatically with this huge cape billowing behind him. You know, he'd strike a pose and say, "I'm Bat Bob." And then all of a sudden the wind would pick up and his cape string would break and his cape would go flying off into the night behind him, and he'd go chasing it across the roof and look down and say, little help. You just kind of set up, this is what this is going to be like. And then I thought, well, wait a minute, you know, he needs Robin, so Larry could be Robin, effectively. So maybe it would be, and the first thing that popped into my head was Bat Bob and Larry Boy.
Well, Larry Boy first appeared in Dave and the Giant Pickle, and that was sort of a costume that Larry donned because he wasn't feeling special as himself, and so he put on this costume of Larry Boy and got stuck to the wall in the countertop scene, and, you know, Bob, you know, brought him down and, you know, told him the story of Dave and the Giant Pickle, you know, which basically taught him that little guys can do big things too and that he should feel special about just being himself. But it was okay to dress up like superheroes.
And so he puts on, you know, a spandex costume with toilet plungers on the side, and I have no idea. I mean, I remember sketching out the costume. I think Chris Olsen came up with the color scheme and actually built it, you know, but I did this little sketch and just thought he needs to have something that makes it look like it's homemade, and he's put it together himself, and it's kind of ludicrous. You know, and out of somewhere came toilet plungers on his head.
Wherever there is trouble, I'll be there. Whatever a helpless vegetable calls out, I will answer. Evildoers, beware. You are no match for the awesome power of Larry Boy and his super suction ears.
And people loved it. They loved the idea, you know, of him and his toilet plungers, and there was just so much possibility there that we thought, okay, we need to do a whole Larry Boy adventure. And hence came the development of Larry Boy, you know, and the Fib from Outer Space, kind of classic, you know, sci-fi 50s feel. Something big comes from outer space, falls to the Earth, and he has to fight it and combat it.
From my standpoint, what I remember most, just beside voice work, you know, and it hurting more to do Larry Boy, because there's just a lot of screaming, "Alfred!" You know, and I just remember my voice hurting a lot coming out of those sessions. We did a million takes, and, you know, because we're just starting, you know, to develop the character.
I've been driving around all day. I'm tired. I'm hungry. I've got to go to the bathroom. This suit is very constricting.
Larry is a little higher and a little squeakier, and then Larry Boy just gets a little gruffer. That's all, a little rougher around the edges.
The monster is headed toward the Bumbleyburg Water Tower. He is carrying a small asparagus. Alfred, we must find a way to stop this beast.
And I also remember the amount of sound effects, because back then I was doing all the editing and sound effects, and with all the machinery of all the toys and the Larry Mobile and, you know, just, you know, all the things that the Fib crunched and broke. I mean, there was much more sound effects work in that show than there had ever been in any previous VeggieTales.
Joseph Pulich, when he came in to apply for a job as, you know, as a designer, and I wanted to know, you know, can you draw funny?
I'm like, well, what does funny mean? How do you draw funny? Yeah, I could draw a funny character, but it wasn't the character. Can you draw funny?
So I said, okay, here's a test. You go home. I'm coming up with this character named Larry Boy. He's got toilet plungers on his ears. Here's what he looks like. And he needs a car, like the Batmobile. You go home and design a car for this superhero. And if I like it, you're hired.
So I was just trying to figure out what could be funny. And then I just figured, well, wouldn't it be funny if Larry, who designed the car, designed it to look just like himself? So I just started drawing different things to make it look like Larry. Before I knew it, it was really just Larry laying down with wheels on him, and then we just added some extra details to it to make it look kind of cool.
And so he came in a couple days later, and he had designed the Larrymobile, you know, toilet plungers for wheels, the whole thing. And I thought, okay, I like him, he draws funny.
Most of what I did was the environments, the backgrounds that you see in the background paintings, and it was the first time in Veggie history that we really put a lot of emphasis on the background paintings. Instead of building everything in the computer that you would see, we build a part of the set that actually needs to be built. There's no other way around it. But areas in the background we can actually paint, and we could actually make it look a little more organic looking, a little more fun and free-flowing than if we actually had to build everything out with 3D geometry. Most of that city scene that you see there is all modeled in 3D geometry. But as the buildings go back in the background, instead of having multiple buildings, there's just a flat piece of geometry with a bunch of painted buildings on it. And then all the sky that you would see are about three different paintings of clouds, different multi-layers, so that as the cloud is moving, that's one painting on one layer, and then the cloud in the background moving in a different direction is on another layer, and another layer, and another layer. And by doing it that way and stair-stepping it that way, we can add a lot of depth and vibrancy in the color that we couldn't really get otherwise. And we could do it at a much faster pace.
With Larry Boy, it's not nearly as light as the stuff we had done before, because I was really trying to parody not just Batman, but specifically Tim Burton's Batman. You know, the dramatic Michael Keaton, "I'm Batman," you know, that thing. Duh! You know, and the gothic score, the Danny Elfman score. So it was a very specific parody. Not just Batman, it's Danny Elfman, Tim Burton's Batman that we're doing here. And the score in particular, you know, Kurt and I worked really, really hard. Kurt, you know, just about killed himself on that score because we wanted to really bring it up a notch. You know, we wanted a men's choir. We wanted it gothic. We wanted, you know, shake your seat kind of stuff. And that was a ton of fun. You know, and I came up with a few of the basic themes. Da 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 da, Larry Boy. You know, some of that stuff. Dum bum 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 bum.
Larry Boy was the first real step into big score. Let's get it as big as we can make it, even though we don't really have a budget to do that. So we got 12 guys, a dozen of them got together. We met one night at the Moody Bible Institute in one of their classrooms and recorded. We were so early in the process that I hadn't written most of the score yet. So I actually wrote out three or four, five pages of just little phrases. Larry, 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 Larry Boy. You know, or the ha, Larry Boy. Those sorts of things. Just writing snippets, dozens of them. Then I had this library of phrases, had them all written down on my paper. There's number 1 through 36. And then would just, as I'm writing, I say, okay, I think, oh, here's a dramatic point. I think it's time for the choir to come in. Okay, here's a phrase. Okay, write in that key up to that point. Drop the choir in, write the orchestra around him, and keep on moving. So that's why you really never hear any long choir phrases in that, because they're just, I almost treated it as one instrument in the orchestra.
I had picked up a kids album done by David Mullen that had just, it wasn't your typical kids album, it had some incredible songs on it. Just, you know, Shake the House, Crank It Up, you know, Move Your Fanny. I mean, really fun stuff. And I was initially thinking, man, I just want to take a couple of these songs and try to use them in a VeggieTales video. But then as we got into Larry Boy, I thought, okay, you know, maybe I can actually work with him to do a song just for Larry Boy, you know, do a theme song. And so, you know, I met with him, gave him that assignment. It's kind of Batman, but, you know, a little twisted, but real big and real fun and kind of big bandy. And he came back, you know, in relatively short order with this, you know, kind of core groove that he wanted to do. Larry Boy, waka 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 waka. And then his wife, you know, Nicole Mullen, actually recorded it and just, you know, blew me away. Like, this is the coolest thing. I can't believe we get to put this in our video, and nobody else can.
I think it's a really cool concept just to have a you know, a superhero who has all of the, you know, right things, you know, has all the equipment, has all the, you know, has the costume and has all the right toys, but, you know, really isn't, you know, all that super. He's a nice guy, but not all that super.
We need to hurry this along. I have a meeting with the action figure people in 10 minutes.
Action figures?
Yes, Bob. Larry Boy Mania is sweeping the nation. If you're not on board, you're gonna miss the train.
I am that!